What the fuck? Welcome to YouTube and what the fuck episode of Darth Urso and is ED failing? Holy shit. What the fuck is going on here? Folks, we're live on YouTube and Twitch and ED servers are down completely. This is some shit. Holy fucking shit. And that's an appropriate icon that I have on my stream right now. For my tile icon on YouTube. Wow. Just wow. I was just making a fucking comment about this to somebody. Lincoln Chatchell. We're back. And fucking Twitch is still trying to run more ads again. Fuck you, Twitch. So, we're back, and we're trying to figure out what's going on with ED. Are we going to get our servers back today, or ever? Because, apparently, let's check ED's. This is fucking insane. It keeps trying to fucking play ads right now, and I'm like, no, snooze it. And it, anyways, I'm just not going to get into Twitch right now. What the fuck? Holy fucking shit. This is insane, y'all. This is seriously some next level fuckery that they've been advertising. They've been advertising sales, new maps, knowing that they've had issues like this. Welcome, Indy. How you been, man? Hold on. Is this not what I've been, like, alluding to? Like, it seems like there's a drug or alcohol problem or a gambling problem because money is not adding up or money is... What the fuck? Yeah, Nick is the problem. No shit. A 0% interest loan from ED. That's embezzlement. You don't borrow or take loans from your company like that. That's embezzlement. What the fuck? And there's even a countdown clock of how long we can use this offline. And they haven't gotten rid of that. What kind of fucking shit is that? So 1 hour. What? Or is that 20 hours and 4 minutes? Fox, just go ahead and send it to me in a DM, a link. Please, here on all right, excuse me, so I can put it up on screen. Thanks, sorry, excuse me. Man, my stomach just rolled. Like, I don't know how many of y'all know this, but I'm physically disabled. Streaming's pretty much my only social outlet because between working, I'm physically beat up after work. I don't have any cartilage left in my knees or ankles. So, like, this is how I socialize, streaming. And I've spent so much money on stuff for fucking, I mean, we all have. I'm not minimizing anybody else, but like I live on a fucking fixed budget. Everybody does, you know what I mean? Like I get help. I have covered California because I can't afford normal health insurance. Like that's why I'm raising money on GoFundMe right now, just so I can go to the fucking hospital and still be able to buy groceries. I've been having some heart issues lately. This shit just fucking, my heart literally just fucking skipped a beat. It's fucking insane. Wags just did a fucking interview the other day with Casmo. Hey, we're pumping this sale. We're pumping this sale. We're pumping this sale. And to do an act like that is straight. Yeah, bro. Indie. Hold on. Leon, are you here? Get your ass in fucking voice chat. We were just talking about this. Like, I told somebody off stream because I didn't want to say it on stream. Thank you, by the way, for sending that, Fox. So, So I read the original Jack in the Crack. Okay. Saving this page. So let's put this up on full screen. Yeah, so that I already showed and read. But so when I was talking to somebody in chat, I was just speaking privately, but I was like, Wags is lying through his fucking teeth. He, it's not about what he was lying. Wags looked like he, what'd you say? It looked uncomfortable in that video. He looked like a fucking hostage that knew all of the fucking way this ways the sausage was made, but wasn't telling us. That's like some Soylent Green shit. Like, I really just watching. I used to work for a private security. Yes. I used to work for a private security firm. That's all I'm going to say. Everything Wags was saying was just uncomfortable stuff. Didn't feel like he was being upfront. The reasons he was giving for them doing Afghanistan or doing the map the way they were doing it and releasing it the way, oh, it helps the customer. All of it was just like, what the fuck are you talking about? And because of that video the other day, I had said to myself, and I don't know if I said this to the person I was in chat with. I don't want to out you. You know who you are. I was just saying, like, in my own head, I was like, I'm, and I actually made the statement on stream, I'm not giving Eagle another fucking dollar until they get some shit squared away. But more so, I'd said, like, I'm never giving them another dollar for early access stuff because I don't think they're being truthful. They don't have release dates. They don't have any kind of completion dates. They don't have any kind of fucking roadmap for us to fucking like, hey, this is our plan. They're literally like crowdsourcing money by all of these pre-sales with no release dates. It's called, what was that? Crowdfunding? Kickstarter. I've spoken, yeah, I refuse to give them more money, same reason. I've spoken directly to several third-party developers, and they all hate Nick without fail, and most don't care for Wags either. It's all a front. Yeah, everything kind of when they did what they did with the Strike Eagle, that kind of just showed me that said a lot. Your biggest release ever outside of your Apache. And this is how you handle it without any updates, without, oh, hey, by the way, this is going on, or hey, this is going on. You don't have to tell us how the sausage is made, but when you have people giving money up for a Kickstarter project, which is essentially what it is until you guys materialize something, you can't behave like that. Right, so let's see what, let's get the Discord back up and let's see what they had to say on Edie's Discord. I want to see that. Plus, not giving the third-party developers access to the. Okay, yeah, Indy. Like, why aren't you giving third-party developers access to APIs? Like, you can't. Who the fuck you think you are, Apple? Oh, I didn't know that, Indy. And thank you for your hard work. I'm just a giga chad that flies a shitload of aircraft. PT, like this has been one of the best things for my PTSD, and I stopped flying. Like those of you who know, I used to fly every fucking day, 5 to 7 hours a day for the stream. And I've literally bounced on it and been driving iRacing and anything else because of what they continue to do by releasing shit updates. And instead of keeping us at a stable, smooth running a version, they just kept pressing and putting out trash updates. My dog needs to poop or pee. She's tripping. But she's also probably sensing my stress because I'm worried that, yeah, bro. Okay, I thought that they had broken the Hornet, but I don't fly her enough to be like, yo, she's for sure broken. But she was behaving super fucking weird, and then shit was not behaving how it should. And Super Carrier, I was having issues. They completely fucked up forestall. Yeah. She felt so fucked up when I was trying to. Okay, so I noticed it big time because I was practicing night traps. And I was like, what the fuck is going on with this aircraft? I was trying to land her at night, and that's when the muscle memory really kicks in those type of conditions. And everything I was doing was wrong, it seemed like. And I was like, man, this is not just me like not flying the Hornet for months. This is something else. All right, let's go to ED's webpage or Discord. Motherfuckers. I gotta figure out where they're fucking. In Discord, can you just search for a server? Is there a toolbar so I can search the instead of going through either one of these or every single one of these to look for it? Oh, fuck it. I guess let's just, Holy shit, I literally wasn't even a member of their official fucking. Nui and Nineline are nuking every comment Razbam related on their Discord. Holy shit. I wonder if anybody thought Darth Urso just joined the server, like, oh shit, nuke this motherfucker immediately before he says something. Winfix server. Nine line. Server is back up at 12:02. Glad I didn't pre-order anything. More than Razbam got by the sounds. Ooh, we'll see how quick they fucking nuke this comment. Somebody tried to react to it, and the reaction got nuked immediately. Still getting authorization errors after booting, rebooting DCS, just no resolution. So, Indy says the fighter collection takes all of the free cash flow, millions of pounds. Here's the thing, like if you would have taken that loan from his company here in the States, not wherever it's registered in fucking Cyprus or wherever, or, I don't know, I'm just talking out my ass. But if it would have been here in the US, his employees could have gone after him or whistleblower, embezzlement. Here's what I think. Now is when MicroProse needs to fucking move in and buy ED out and just get rid of fucking Nick Ray. Nine line. I have asked management about it, but it was really supposed to be between the two managements, so if he has anything to share, what? Can we expect any communication from ED about all of this? So supposedly the servers are back up. Yeah, if they get rid of Nick, the company will flourish. Who else is excited about paying for a plane that's not getting updates? And no shit. Fucking strike eagle. All right, let's restart the sim and see if the servers are back up. He only became CEO because his friend died. He doesn't even care about DCS, only his warbirds. Yeah, quote of the day. I knew getting into DCS wasn't going to be a smooth ride, but this is wild as fuck. Quote of the fucking day. Big Newie, folks, a reminder, please keep to the hashtag rules and do not troll. Newie, stick to the truth and you won't have us trolling you. For lying to us repeatedly and fucking us around with our fucking money, because you're not fucking with other people. You're not just fucking with Razbam's money. You're fucking with every single person who's giving you cash over the last fucking year that you guys have been shitting on us. How's that, chat? Is that about facts? Oh my god. Are the servers back up? The servers are back up. Folks, let me take the doge out. I'll be right back. I'm still surprised nobody said anything on YouTube about it yet. I think I'm the first person up on YouTube right now broadcasting about this. Ban incoming in 5, 4, 3, Indy. I'm typing something before I take her out. So I typed, this is wild. I'm physically disabled, and this was a huge part of my only way to socialize flying. To think I just threw away all this money. We need transparency, please. Wow. You know, it's popping up when ED Discord is locked on several people typing in both nine line and BN chat. That's are up constantly. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. This is wild. Oh, fuck. Okay, there we go. I'm scrolling up. And let's see what happened. This is why you don't pre-order. Wow. This is fucking wild, y'all. All these fanboys defending ED. Beta testers talking to some Razbam developers might get banned by eight lines for that nine line. We put eight line just so you wouldn't get hit. This is fucking crazy. Apparently, Wags used to work on, the rumor is that he used to work on, not rumor, I mean, it's been told to me that he used to work on Falcon, and he's credited in the manual. Yeah, that's crazy. That's just lawsuit sim 2024. Well, let's do some flying while we still have a DCS world to fly, folks. This is fucking wild. Oh, I was like, what? I got a direct message from ED already? It's just ED bot saying welcome. Like, what the fuck? Holy shit. This is just insanity, folks. Okay, the Doge really needs to go out, and I'm still surprised, like. Nobody's. It's wild. That's wild. Okay, let me take the Doge out. I'm sorry, folks. She's really got to go to the bathroom. I'm sitting here chatting with you guys. To be frank, having played ED shit since lock-on Mac and having hands-on with ED commercial products, this is nothing new. Yeah, I've been kind of critical of them for a while, but it was just because of the fact that they don't take fucking responsibility. Like, let me take her out real quick. I'm sorry. I'll be right back. Okay. Let's check out Gonker and Movie, Mover and Gonky real quick. Gonky and Mover. Yeah. Let's check out the boys real quick. I'll be right back, folks. Let me take the Doge out.
So in the news, and everybody keeps sending me this, so I figured we'd talk about it, even though neither of us flew F-5s.
I'll be right back.
So it's E-38. The F-5 is going to the Marines, which they fly them out of what, Yuma?
Yuma, yeah.
Is there anywhere else?
Pretty sure just Yuma. That's the aggressor.
So the Navy flies them now, Key West and New Orleans. That's it.
Yeah.
Because Fallon went to Vipers.
Yep.
And now the Marines just have them at Yuma. They use them for adversary training, and the Swiss were getting rid of them at around 1.5 million each. Dude, we should have started a GoFundMe.
We'd probably be pretty close to that 1.5 mil.
I think
I
so.
mean,
They're going to be adversaries. They got 22 of them, so
we just
spares
needed
for the,
two, really.
yeah, dude, spares for the spares. Really, we could have gotten away with one, you know? I mean, I'm not going to fly it all the time. My back can't take that. So yours can't either. So,
Yeah, we could be each other's crew chiefs. I launch you launch me. My neck hurts. Your turn. Yeah, it's like, no, your other left. Wait, are you looking?
How did you ground loop it, Gonky? So these are secondhand F5s, but they're setting up detachments at multiple bases back in 2017. They
Stop that
are in the
news.
training program, capable of reaching speeds of Mach 1.63, maybe.
Ish.
Yeah. But they have a 20 mic, as we saw in the DCSs. And the real thing is they're cheap. They're cheap to operate, they're cheap to buy, but they are upgraded with Garmin G3000. Interesting thing, I was trying to get the T-38s we were flying upgraded to this. The commander of the Tufts was like, hey, can you reach out to any contacts in the Navy and find out, because they wanted to figure out a way to do this, because the G3000 gives them a whole range of mission equipment for integration, including helmet-mounted displays, which is good when you're doing adversary work and supporting stuff, and electronically scanned radar. And it goes back to, dude, technology, right? This thing had a range-only radar when it first came out,
All right,
and
I'm back, folks.
now you can put an ESA in it, and it's 150 pounds. Just have to wire it. Next thing you know, guess what? You got a lightweight fighter. I mean,
Yeah.
other than its age. So I thought that was cool. And I wanted to ask you, Gonki, do you think this is a better adversary option than something else, some other? Like, do you think this is the most cost-effective way to get cheap adversary air for the Marines?
Yes, only because they've been doing it with the F5, so to speak, for so many
Yeah.
years. So logistically, everything's laid out. All the training programs are laid out. Excuse me, maintenance is doped out. And I actually think the F5 is a really good aggressor platform. I've mentioned it before in the show. A lot of the times doing the big exercises, it's the F5 that gets you. Everybody's worried about the
Yeah.
Big scary stuff, Su-30, whatever coming at you. So everyone's looking at that. Nobody sees the F5 coming at you. I mean, we would kill them a lot, but you know, it, you know, and like us flying 38s, man, right? We would,
yeah, I mean, hard to see
an F-22.
Yeah, right? I mean, these what you see a lot, and I saw this when I flew the F-16, guys and girls that fly big jets get eyeball calibrated to big jets. So your 45-foot wingspan looks a lot different than your 33-foot wingspan, looks a lot different than your 25-foot wingspan. And so, like, you take a little F5 with the needle nose on, it's a hard, it's a dot. It's hard to see. Now, I mean, remember when we did this, you know, we once you flew the T-38 for a little while, you could see everything because you just knew what you were looking for. And compared to the black dot that the T-38 was, the F-22 was, you know, might as well have been a 737 because it was just a big honking airplane.
Hello, Rhythmic Harry.
And so that's good training by itself. I agree with you that it's great because, you know, they've been doing it. But the other part, too, is when you're buying 22, if you've got the pilots to do it, you know, it goes back to what we talked about at the start of the show about putting a lot of airplanes out. And that's good to train against. So if I can gin up my own large force exercise in-house and I don't have to go out to other units and other agencies and contract writer and all that stuff, dude, I can get good training with what I already have, and it only cost me $1.5 million. So, and I'm using off-the-shelf stuff is so good. It's getting around the government contract bloat and bureaucracy. That is the problem. But once you can do that and just go buy an off-the-shelf Garmin and, you know, you got moving map and all that stuff, dude, that's a formidable opponent. And it's simulating a lot of good stuff.
Yeah. I mean, we experienced some of that in the T-38, right? I mean, it's not like we flew the A model, which was a twin-engine Cessna 152 from like 1950, right? Steam gauges, the whole works. But we had a GPS unit. It was just one off the shelf that we had to, and they literally made brackets. Yep. Right. I mean, we used off the shelf stuff, like you said, Mover, to get around the bureaucracy and this just the slowness of any kind of military kind of procurement plan.
Well, I mean, poor man's Datalink, you know, the ADSB and the, you know, I mean, dude, we knew we were each other. We could find each other in the airspace because the ADSB
game changer. Right.
Yeah.
I think it's a good.
All right. The question is there going to be any like differences in the Javelin Daddy has been warned. Yeah, they're Edie bot waved at somebody who asked, "Hey guys, is Edie in financial trouble?" Their Discord is on fire. They've disabled picture sharing. Yep, you can't share GIFs or anything. They're definitely fucking blocking it. GIFs, anything.
Nine line. Look, I was just trying to lighten the mood. I apologize if I insulted you, but it is a bit hectic in here, and you really do not have anything to worry about. Edie is healthy, and this will pass. I can't. Oh my god. Somebody put as a response to that, I can think of 10 million reasons why they've disabled picture sharing. The loan that Nick Gray took. Wow. Thank you for your passion and support. All of a sudden, we can... All of a sudden, somebody was able to post a fucking GIF. Yep, and people are commenting on Nick Gray's aircraft collection. Wow. Just fucking wild. At Darth Urso, I got warned. You're sending links from that website isn't allowed in DCS by Eagle Dynamics. It's the GIF app from Discord. I got counseled for trying to post a GIF. We have talked about wanting to get an update out in the newsletter. Fuck out of here. Alright, let's do some flying while we still have this fucking sim, y'all. Jesus Christ. And Nine Line responded to me. Not every gift is acceptable here. Let's do some flying. This is fucking wild. Fuck me, man. I'm having heart issues right now, and I need money for the fucking hospital and for doctor's visits. Just thinking about how much money I can get out of my flight gear. That's fucking crazy that I even had that thought. I've got health insurance, but it's covered California. It doesn't pay for shit, really. What the fuck? Well, DCS just completely fucking crashed on me.
Can I get a hug?
Need a big hug from the service doge. Crash again? And let's fly a Razbam aircraft. That'd be fucked up if they borked their aircraft code. That'd be a lawsuit just waiting to happen. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if we see some fucking lawsuits out of this shit if they fuck around and... what the fuck? None of my controls are registering. What the fuck? Okay, that works now. That works now.
Warning, AMAD, fire. Warning, AMAD, fire.
Oh, holy shit, that explains some of the shit that I've been experiencing in the Strike Eagle and why it's an issue. The Razbam said, fuck you, we're not updating the aircraft.
Warning, AMAD, fire. Warning, AMAD, fire. Warning, engine, fire, left. Warning, engine, fire, left. Warning, engine, fire, right. Warning, engine, fire, right.
Like, certain weapons that they just released, like the AGM-154, try updating it on the center pylon after you change loadouts after the aircraft started. You can't do it, because they didn't add the AGM-154 into the air-to-ground menu. So you can't add it.
Warning, AMAD, fire. Warning, AMAD, fire. Warning, engine, fire, left. Warning, engine, fire, left. Warning, engine, fire, right. Warning, engine, fire, right. AB burn through, left. AB burn through, left. AB burn through, right. AB burn through, right.
Everybody's flying their Strike Eagle while they can. Why is Discord still pumping me with alerts? Wire while you can. Like, they should have fixed this. This was fixed, I thought, where it was updating the weapons loadouts, but all of a sudden it's not working? What the fuck? Acid 1-1, comm check.
4-3-3, Overlord, 1-1, pop-up group, 097, 4-250, at 1,000.
Acid 1-1, comm check.
Loud and clear.
4-3-3, Overlord.
Anybody else worried about if we're going to be able to fly? What the fuck is going on here? Yo, did they bork the Strike Eagle? What the fuck? Why can't I... Alright, now it's working for some reason.
4-3-3, Overlord, 1-1, pop-up group, 1-1-2, 4-160, at 7,000, hot. Overlord, 1-1, bra, 1-1-2, 4-190, at 25,000, cold.
All right. Duck, I have my volume up on SRS and your voice was super low. You might want to turn your mic sensitivity up a little bit. It's so low. I have to... My volume's cranked too. Well, folks, hopefully this won't be the last couple of days of flying with DCS. Keep your fingers crossed. Hopefully MicroProse buys them out or something. Napa traffic, ask you to 11 taxiing to active runway 22 holding short. Napa ATC, ask you to 11 taxiing onto active runway 22 and pushing 10. You know what's crazy? It's actually running smoother than it's run all week now. That's wild. Up north again. God damn it. That's why the TAC can's broken. You can't use the TAC can to guide you to the tanker because it'll just steer you wherever the fuck. Not to the tanker, though, that's for sure. We could try it again to see if it works, but it hasn't been working. Yeah, what the fuck? That's a little fucked up. We better be on a predictive course because it wasn't working like that before. We'll see. We'll see. Yeah, I'm not trusting it. Better intercept than it was giving me. Autopilot's off. Why the fuck is my... Let's find out. What did that say? 133 for 10? What?
Overlord 1-1-4-3.
Okay, I thought I was hearing things, so just hearing shit.
3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 4,
Overlord 1-1, pop-up group 144, 4-1 under.
I had to do something real quick. Send a message out for work. What kind of fucking flight pattern is that shit? The fuck is that shit? What in the fuck? What the fuck did they do with these fucking tankers? Come on. That is wild. 4-3-3, now Twitch is tripping on their app. Let's do this. This fucking flight pattern that these fucking things are flying. What the fuck is this bullshit? I'm gonna overfly this because I just looked at chat and something's going on with fucking Twitch. What the fuck? All right, let's get some gas.
Contact.
3 contact.
What up, Ike? Just give me a second. 1 second, chat. How you doing?
Contact. You're taking fuel.
Well, it wasn't going at all this morning because ED servers were down. You know about the drama going on right now, buddy? What the fuck? All right, we're good to go. The fuck?
Overlord 11433, request bogey dope.
Yeah, it's crazy what's going on. Like, all of the servers were down. How do you explain that post being made by Red Spam? And then the servers being down, all of that stuff just coinciding with today. I'm wondering if they did have some bills unpaid. Servers were part of it. What you been up to, Ike? You flying? I haven't been flying for months. Been driving iRacing, anything but flying because of the fuckery that I thought was going on, and I wasn't happy with the state of things, and then all of this shit starts popping off when I do come back to flying. Like, what the fuck? Wow. Cedar 11, Fox 3 times 2, SU-33 at 35,000 feet, descending to 18. Flanker. Acetyl 1-1, splash 1. Cedar 1-1, engage multiple bandits, 14,000, 15,000, 16,000. Box 3 times 3.
Thank you.
That's here, 11 Fox 3. What the fuck? Helldivers and War Thunder haven't flown for a while. Gotta love aircraft still teleporting. Of course, we know why, but, you know, hey. I had the advantage, and then I didn't. Literally, aircraft just teleporting.
We've arrived at the target warehouse. Setting up security.
That's not a good sign. Been that way. It's gotten, the teleporting got so much worse with 2.9. I'm not trying to fucking fly up. All the way up north to just go hit a fucking tanker, though, so it's kind of shit. I really wish Hoggett would correct that stuff. Fine, put tankers up here flying your fucked up routes, but then you've got a MPRS down here off the coast. Give us a KC-135 down off the coast, too. They've got two MPRSs here, but only one KC-135. But that's Hoggett, that's not ED. How you been? Yeah, I don't have Helldivers, but all my friends that have it have been loving it. I've just been driving iRacing mostly, and I started playing some Call of Duty again because Rebirth Island came back, but that's only been within the last week. But my stomach needs food. Oh, you race iRacing, Ike? I drive open wheel, F3, F4, Formula One, GT3 cars, LMP. I've got the Cadillac for LMP. All road racing. Road racing or open wheel. I really like the open wheel. I dig the speed. In fact, while I go grab a refresh on the coffee, here's what we'll do. I'm going to put the screen capture up real quick so you guys can see what I'm into. I'm only going to be gone for like 2 minutes, 3 minutes. I just have to reheat this coffee. 1 second. Bang. Bang. And let's see what Dark does when he's not flying. Oh, man, what do you think of the rain with iRacing? I was just going to say. Yeah, the rain is amazing. All right, let me reheat this coffee. I'll be right back.
Welcome to the fuck shop. That's 20 minutes to go, 20 minutes.